Here's that bag I picked up this past weekend at one of the yard sales. Really happy with this purchase. The thing's in like new condition, very durable, very rugged, and actually has a lot more pockets than I thought. Pockets within pockets, and in my opinion, will hold 2 to 3 days worth of bug out and survival gear. One of my favorite features are these loops on the outside, so anything I can't fit on the inside, I'll be able to hopefully strap to the outside of it. One of which will be a wallet-sized solar panel I plan on getting to recharge rechargeable batteries for flashlights and radios, walkie-talkies, and things like that. Now, I wanted to start putting stuff in this as soon as possible without having to go to the store and spend extra money. So I started thinking what I might have around the house that I can start putting in here that would be great for bugging out. And so that's what I'd like to show you now, some items that I found. And we'll start off with these cotton balls. I happen to have a whole bag of these. And what I plan on doing is taking this hand sanitizer that happens to have a lot of alcohol in it and soaking these cotton balls with it. And that way I'll have a tinder to get some fires going. Something else I'll be able to do is whenever I get a scratch or something like that, because this is hand sanitizer and an antiseptic, I'll also be able to keep them clean to prevent infection. And to keep them from drying out and to keep them moist, I will keep them in Ziploc bags. Something else I came across that I thought was real cool and I learned about recently on the Do-It-Yourself World YouTube channel was what some of the things you can do with feminine products. I happened to find these under the bathroom sink here. This tampon here, and it looks like a feminine pad. They happen to be 100% sterile. And one of the great uses that I thought of that I would use them for at first was just tinder to help get fire started with the cotton in them and stuff like that. But the uses that I learned on the do-it-yourself world was for puncture wounds. So what you would do is take one of these and put it in the puncture wound, be it from a bullet wound or an arrow or some type of self-inflicted wound, remove the plastic applicator, and then what would happen is the tampon, I guess, will expand in the wound to help stop bleeding and keep prevent infection. So that's really cool. And then I have this feminine pad that I felt would be good for tinder, for starting fires, and or using as a huge bandage to help keep infection out of a sore or a wound, if you will. So anyway, that was really cool. And then I came across some aspirin. Now, I think this is real important. I don't think in an apocalyptic situation we're going to be able to go to our local drugstore and just buy this medicine. And I think this will be good for trading and stuff like that. Now, you may notice it makes a lot of noise, so I'm definitely going to want to transfer these into a more quiet container, as we certainly don't want to be attracting attention to ourselves in a bug-out situation. From what I've learned, we want to be as stealthy as possible. Some other medicine that I came across was some anti-diarrheal medicine. Diarrhea is a no-no. Diarrhea accelerates dehydration, and that's what we don't want. We want to stay hydrated. So this is really good to have around. This will definitely be going with me, and I also think this will be good for training. Also have, I don't know about you people out there, I happen to suffer from heartburn. And I don't want to be dealing with what I feel is one of the worst pains on the planet during a bug-out situation, so this will definitely be going with me as well. Now, about 2 months ago, maybe three, my birthday, and anyway, I'm always popping buttons here and there, so my mom got me a sewing kit, and haven't even opened it yet, but I got to thinking, if I get a bad cut that won't stop bleeding on its own, I'll be able to use this to sew that cut shut. Be very painful, but hey, have to do it to survive, right? What else did I find? Some tape. There's all kinds of uses for tape. This is nice and small, compact, so that's definitely going to go with me. I'm sure I'll be able to find many good uses for that tape. We may be on foot a lot, so one of the most important things you can have in that situation is a fresh pair of socks, dry socks. So I definitely want to make sure I have some alternate socks in my bug out bag. So those are going to make it in there. Out on my porch, I found this solar-powered light, and so that'll come in handy at night. Doesn't need to have replacement batteries, just charge it every day, and that way I'll have some light to read with and be able to see what's going on around me at night. And light makes you feel safe and secure, so I want to have as much of that as possible, along with the fires. What else did I come across? Oh yeah, this nail file happens to be really rough, but would be great for resharpening knives and or fishing hooks. So that's definitely going to make it in the bug out bag. Also came across some Band-Aids, and now I do plan on getting a first aid kit that a small, tight, compact with more stuff in it, but for now, again, just things around the house. I have some Band-Aids, and so those are going to go in the bag for now. This one happens to be waterproof, which is pretty cool, so that'll go in there. Then I came across some fishing line, and there's enough here that I might be able to give some to some other people for some items they might have that I could use. and definitely want to be able to catch some fish and have some food in my belly. So came across some sweets that I'll be able to have in there. Sweets make you feel good, also provide energy, gives you something to eat, help may hold you over to your next meal. So I definitely want to make sure those sweets make it into the bug out bag. trash bag ties. Not quite sure all the uses these might have. If there's any of you out there that might know, please let me know. But the one thing I thought of was on the bug out bag, I can use them to keep things on the outside of it, maybe keep them secure and hook them on there. So that's one use I might be able to do with that. So anyway, again, if you know of any other uses I might find with these, please comment and let me know. Came across these batteries, which I will have rechargeable batteries, but until then, these will do. What else do I have here? Oh yeah, an apocalyptic event. Are we gonna be able to just go to the dentist when we have a toothache? Probably not. So I definitely want to make sure I keep the teeth clean to prevent cavities. Don't want to be going through a toothache in a bug out situation. So that's going to go. And then I found this razor. I want to take this along. I want to stay as cleanly shaven as possible. Avoid shitter bugs or chigger bugs, whatever you call them, red bugs, ticks and things like that, lice. And so I want to stay as well shaven as possible. Keep the hygiene up. And I also came across, what else? This old pack of matches. Yes, there's only 4 matches. Heck, I might be able to get 2 or 3 fires out of it, so that's definitely gonna make it in there. And I do plan on getting the waterproof matches with the watertight container, but for now, if I can get 1 or 2 fires started with this, I'm definitely gonna take it with me. And got a rag, help keep myself dry, think clean, things like that, so that's gonna go. And I think there's one more thing here. Got some soap. Want to stay as clean as possible. When you're clean, you feel better. And the cleaner you are, I think, the less chance you have of getting sick.
Video earlier, there's like a few items so that I failed to mention that I found around the house that I want to talk to you about now. One of which is this box of kasha. Basically, kasha is buckwheat. Okay. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, buckwheat. Buckwheat fills you up, makes you feel nice and full. It's easy to cook. All it requires is boiling water, just like a cooking rice. And what's really cool is it has 35 grams of carbohydrates per serving, and which is going to provide a lot of energy, and that's something we're going to need a lot of in a bug out situation. So I definitely want to make sure this makes it into the bug out bag. Something else I failed to mention earlier were these Q-tips that I found in the medicine chest, and these will have a few purposes actually, one of which will be for applying medicines on the wounds. I can also use it for tinder to get fires started. And last but not least, want to keep the old ears clean because I definitely want to be able to hear everything that's going on around me in a bug out situation. Want to be alert and aware. Something else I failed to mention was this can of tuna that I found in the kitchen cabinet. And the only problem with it is it doesn't have an easy open tab on the top. So I'm definitely going to want to invest in one of those P38 can openers, also known as a John Wayne can opener, so I can get into this can. Not only this can, but any other cans that are like it I may encounter in the future. Lots of protein in that one, so I'll definitely make sure that goes in the bug out bag. Might want to get some breath mints too after eating that. No one's going to want to talk to me. Anyway, also, last but not least, you may have noticed throughout the video this book. I found the thickest book I could find in my library, which is absolutely tiny, maybe 3 books. Anyway, it's my opinion after an apocalyptic event, we're not going to have cellular phone service, we're not going to have cable television, we're not going to have satellite TV, no Wi-Fi, none of that stuff. None of those luxuries will be around anymore. So definitely going to need to have something to entertain myself, and I think everyone should. And so I'll have this book for reading to do that. And hopefully if I'm lucky, I'll run into other preppers who also brought some books, and maybe we can trade so we can have fresh reading material. So anyway, I wanted to cover those items with you, make sure you understood I found those, and that they're going in that bug out bag as well.
So anyway, those are all the items I found laying around the house I can start stocking my bug out bag with. I challenge you to do the same thing. Have a look around your place and see if there aren't some items that you might already have that you too can use in a bug out situation. Start building up your bug out cache with your bug out bag. And until next time, America, don't forget, wake up, okay? Take care. See ya.